Dear students, let us study about the teapot program which is present in the computer graphics and visualization laboratory. This is the program number 6 in the laboratory, and here we have to draw a simple shaded scene which is consisting of a teapot on a table. Define suitably the position and properties of the light source along with the properties of the surfaces of the solid object used in the scene. So here we have to use the material properties and the light properties. To use them, we have to make use of the light APIs as well as the material APIs. A teapot will be placed on a table, and the table will be consisting of tabletop and four legs. Here the scene will be consisting of two walls and one floor. So we will see how we can go for implementing this particular scene, the material properties, the light properties, as well as placing a teapot on the table. In this one, let us look at the first function, that is the OBJ function. The OBJ function, it is consisting of 6 parameters. This OBJ function, it is consisting of rotate, translate, scale, and the for a object what we want to do, that is a solid cube, and then the identity matrix API. We can see here this OBJ, it is consisting of 3 parameters here, that is TX, TY and TZ, that is the translation on the X axis, the translation on the Y axis and the translation on the Z axis. The next 3 parameters are concerned with the scaling. So here we have the scaling on the X direction, the scaling on the Y direction and the scaling on the Z direction. First API is for the rotate, and in the rotate we are having the D here. This is for the decimal value. So we are having the rotate API which will be having 4 parameters. The first parameter is for the angle, and then we have the X axis, Y axis and the Z axis. So here by using this GL rotate API, I am rotating an object on an angle of 50 degrees along the Y axis. So which object has been rotated, this object will be given at the end of this rotation here. Whatever object has been specified after the statements for the transformation, that object will be affected by these transformations, scaling and rotations. So here we are having the glut solid cube 1. So this is one API which is used for creating a cube of size 1. So based on this solid cube, these rotations, translation as well as the scaling is applied. So from the OBJ function, we are going to the rotate. We are having 3 rotate APIs here. These 3 rotate APIs are written for rotating a solid cube on the Y direction, on the minus X direction and the minus Z direction. These values are got for a suitable position, how we can look at a teapot at an angle. See, if I am going to place the teapot at the center, or if I am going to place the view at the center, it will be not very perfect. So, but when I am going for this particular rotation values, then we are getting the view what I'll show in the output. You can change these values and see how actually the scenario will be different. So for this particular angle, the best view will be got for the teapot. That is the reason why we're going to make use of these values. These values are got by trial and error. We can go for changing them, and then we can go for looking at the teapot program in different ways. So here we have the GL translate API. GL translate D is for the double value, and the TX, TY and TZ. So whatever value has been given in these 3 parameters, that is TX, TY and TZ, it will be passed to the GL translate API. The next 3 values, they are given for the scaling. So after taking the rotate values, the translate values and the scaling value, this solid cube will be transformed now. So the transformation is applied in the form of scaling, translating as well as rotating. That means one solid cube is taken, which is of size 1, and then we have a scaling. That means it is made big or small. That is called as a scaling. Here we are increasing the size of the solid cube with respect to the values what has been given in the SX, SY and SZ. Then we are moving the solid cube by using the translate API, and then we are rotating the solid cube by using the GL rotate APIs. So GL load identity is a API which is used for clearing all the previous values, and then we can go for combining the solid cube values along with the matrix content. So we have a display function here. In the display function, the viewport, it is having a value of 00, 700 and 700. For the viewport, the origin is 00 and the size of the viewport is given by 700 and 700. And in the GL clear, we are clearing the color buffer bit. That is, the frame buffer bit has been cleared over here. And then also we are clearing the depth buffer bit. After doing this, now I'm going for the OBJ function. So in the OBJ function, we know that the first three parameters are for the translation and the next three parameters are for the scaling. So when you look at the translation over here, we can see that we are having on the Z direction, we are having 0.5. And then on the X and the Y, we are having the value as 0. So this OBJ function, it is having the first three parameters for the translation. That means the object will be moved in the Z direction by a value of 0.5. It is not moved on the X or the Y, but on the Z it is moved by 0.5. The next three parameters you can observe here, it is for the scaling. Scaling means, you can see here, the X value is written as 1. That means the solid cube 1 what was there, the X value is written as 1. And the Y value is also written as 1, but the Z value has been reduced to 0.04. So the Z value, when it is reduced to 0.04, now this will give a wall. That means I take a solid cube of size 1 cross 1 cross 1. That means the width is 1, the height is 1, as well as the depth is 1. So X, Y, Z value, which is equal to 1. Previously, we have seen in the previous slide, the solid cube 1, what is there. For this solid cube 1, now I am applying this OBJ values. So this OBJ will create a new wall. That means this OBJ will create a new solid cube with these values applied on the solid cube with the value as 1. So this OBJ function, it is used for reducing the solid cube 1 by giving the translation, rotation and scaling. So here we are having the solid cube 1 and I am going to translate it by a value of Z 0.5, and then I am going to scale it by making use of 0.04 on the Z axis. That means I am going to retain the X value as 1, the Y value as 1, but the Z value will be equal to 0.04. Now what happens? The width will be the same, the height will be the same, but the depth what is there, that has been reduced by 0.04. When this happens, the thickness of the Z value will become less. And this one, it is nothing but, it is a wall now. It gives rise to a wall. And this wall is placed at an angle what has been specified in your previous rotation APS. At an angle of 50 degree on the Y axis, 10 degree on the minus X axis, and 11.7 degrees on the minus Z. So this is the rotation. These are the rotations what we are going to apply for the solid cube 1 to give rise to the first wall, that is the wall 1. The next OBJ function, it is used for creating the floor. So how it is used for creating the floor means you can observe in the last three values. That means the last three values are concerned with the scaling. We are retaining the x value as 1. We are retaining the z value as 1. But we are making the y value as 0.04. The meaning is I am having the height reduced, whereas I am going to keep the depth as well as the width 1 as well as 1. The same as a solid cube 1. When I do this for a solid cube and I'm going to reduce only on the y direction is equal to 0.04, then we will observe that this object, that is a solid cube 1 what was there, when it is pressed from the top, I'm going to get the value here as 0.04 for the y direction, and it will be compressed on the y direction and I'm going to get the floor here. So if you consider the translation, because we have to get a view where the two walls has to be merged together, so I am going to, and the floor should be based on the bottom of this one. So we go for this particular value of the translation. That means on the y direction, I am going to have minus 0.5. So I am going to pull down this solid cube on the y direction with a value of minus 0.5. When I do this one, then I'm going to get the floor for the scene here. The next OBJ function, it is used for creating the wall which is on the right side, where you can see here the last three parameters which is concerned with the scaling. You can see that for the x value it is the least, whereas the y and z are left as it is. That means I am going to take a solid cube and I am going to reduce the x value, that is the width will be reduced by 0.04. When you give this value as 0.04, then we are having a wall constructed, and this wall, it has to be moved towards the right, and that is the what we are going to do when I am going to apply the translation here, minus 0.5. So when I apply in the x direction, I am going to move it in minus 0.5. That means I am going to move it to the right side. When I do this, then I am going to get the right wall. This OBJ 0, minus 0.3 and the next three OBJs, they are used for creating the four table legs. These four table legs will be at a distance from each other. And you can look at the last three values in the table legs. Because they are concerned with the scaling, you can see that in the x direction it is 0.02, y direction it is 0.2, and we have the z direction 0.02. That means the y value what we are having, that is the maximum, which tells that the length of the leg should be, that means the height of the leg should be more, and the z parameter as well as the x parameter, it is kept at 0.02, which is 10 times lesser. That means I'm having a table leg which will be lengthier, but the x value and the z value will be kept as 0.02, which means the solid cube is taken, one solid cube with the value as 1 is taken, and then the scaling is done. When we scale down, that means what was equal to 1, now it has been reduced to 0.02 on the x direction, 0.2 on the y direction, 0.02 on the z direction. So these three values are concerned with the scaling on the x direction, y direction and the z direction. The first three parameters, they are concerned with the translation. The first table leg, it is placed at minus 0.3 from the y direction, on the y direction along the y axis. And the second OBJ function is used for creating the next table leg. You can see the table leg's proportion, it is same. That means we take a solid cube and then I'm going to increase it by 0.2 on the y direction, but I'm going to give it as 0.02 on the x and the z direction, which means that the highest value is equal to 0.2. And then for this table leg, I'm going to make use of x value 0, 0, minus 0.3, minus 0.4 in the translation. That means this table leg will be placed minus 0.3 on the negative y-axis and minus 0.4 on the minus z-axis. This is the second table leg what I'm going to get. That small table leg what is there in the scene, that is this particular table leg. The third table leg is got by the OBJ minus 0.3 and 0. So in this we can observe that the third table leg is having its x value as 0.4. That means the translation is done on the positive x direction. And then we have the y value as minus 0.3 and the z value is equal to 0. Similarly, the fourth table leg is also generated by using the fourth OBJ over here. And then the last OBJ function, it is used for creating the table top. The table top is also constructed by taking a solid cube of size 1. A solid cube of size 1 is taken, and then we are having the scaling here as 0.6, 0.02 and 0.6. You can observe here the x value and the y value, it is equal to 0.6 and 0.02. The x value is 0.6 over here, and previously when I am using the table leg, you can see that the table leg should be having less value than this because the table leg will be much smaller than the table top. So for the table top, you can see here the y value is equal to the least. Y value should be equal to least means the thickness should be the least, whereas the x value and the z value, it is maintained as 0.6. If it is 0.8 or something also, it is okay, but it should be lesser than 1 here. So to give a exact picture how actually the difference will be there, we have taken the value here is to be as 0.6. So for the table top, the tilting has been done. That means the translation has been done by using 0.2, minus 0.8 and minus 0.2. And all the OBJs what we have studied up till here, it is giving us the objects which are used for constructing two walls, one floor, four table legs and one table top. So totally 8 OBJs will be used here. These 8 OBJs are concerned with two walls, one floor, four legs, and then we are having one table top. Now coming to the next GL rotate set of APIs. These three GL rotate APIs and the translate, they are applied on this glut solid teapot. The glut solid teapot is one API which is used for giving us a teapot. So the teapot is one object. So this object, it can be created by using the glut solid teapot. So we are taking here the glut solid teapot as 0.09. This glut solid teapot, the translation is given in the GL translate. For this glut solid teapot, the rotation is given in terms of these three rotations. We don't have any scaling over here because already we have scaled down the teapot from 1 to 0.09. So we don't need any scaling. It is just making use of 0.09. We can still reduce the teapot size here. The teapot will become smaller. So as usual, the GL flush API is used for clearing all the APIs and executing all the APIs. And the GL load identity is one API which is used for clearing the previous data what is present in the matrices and going for a neat calculations of the values. So in the main function, I am having the argument count and the argument list. We are initializing the argument count and the argument list to the glut system. Then I have an array which is called as the ambient. So we know that ambient means it is uniform lighting. So in the ambient array, I'm going to make use of four values. Here it is 1111, which shows that here it is for R, G, B and A. So the R is for the red, then we have the green component, then we have the blue component, and then I have the alpha component. So here the ambient, when I'm using all the four values as one, that means I want a uniform lighting here. I want a uniform white light over here. That is why I'm going to make use of this ambient 1, 1, 1 and 1. So the light position. The light position here, it is giving where actually this light has been placed. So the light position is going to give us the light, the where actually the light is being present over here. So the first three parameters are with respect to the x, y and z. And when the last parameter, it is a non-zero value, that means the light position is at a distance, we can say. So when it is a non-zero value, it is at a distance. And that is why we are giving here the value as 3. It can be any non-zero value. So the first three values are with respect to the x value, y value and the z value. The light is positioned in your scene at this particular values. And then I'm having the glut init window size. The window size here is taken to be as 700 and 700. I'm going to give the title of this window by using a title called as scene. And then I use the glut display function to call the display function. And then I have to enable the lighting, because in my program here, I should go for making use of a light. So if I should make use of a light, I should go for awning that light. To enable that light, we have to make use of an API called as GL enable GL lighting. This GL lighting is a constant which is used for enabling the lighting characteristics. So once this lighting characteristics has been enabled, how many light are we using? That should be given by GL enable GL light 0. Totally we can make use of 8 lights in the scene. Here I am using only 1 light. So I am going to have GL enable GL light 0. If I am using more light, means I have to make use of one more GL enable to enable the next light. So here we are having GL enable GL light 0 to indicate that only one light is present in my scene. Now we'll go for the GL material FV. The GL material FV is an API which is used for specifying the materialistic properties for the materials in the scene. So for all the materials in the scene, I am going to apply some effect. What effect? On which face it has to be seen, that is given in the first parameter. The first parameter is the, it can be GL front, it can be GL back, or it can be GL front and back. So the first parameter concerned with which face of the material has to be affected. So I am going to choose the GL front. So GL material F is for the floating values, and V is, we are going to select the values from a vector, where we're going to make use of a ambient vector. So GL front is the first parameter. In the first parameter, we are telling which materials, which material phase has to be highlighted. So here we're having the GL front. The next parameter is a GL ambient. The GL ambient is a constant which is used to indicate that the lighting in this is uniform. The material, all the material what is present over here, for all the material, the lighting is uniform. And then I am having the third parameter, which is called as the ambient. This third parameter ambient, we are going to get these values for the ambient from the previous array. That is, this ambient array, it is going to be used over here, this ambient. And then the GL light FV is one API which is used for giving the light properties. So how many lights are we using? That is given in the first parameter. So this is light zero. That means the first light. The light FV is affecting which light? That means how many lights I am using. Light number is given here. That is the GL light zero. Then GL position. At which position? This is a positional light. That is why we are going to give it as GL position. And the light position, of course, it is present in an array called as light position here. So this light position array is made use of in this GL light FV. So light position, it is made use of in this GL light FV API. And then GL enable, GL depth test is used for the Z buffer enabling. The Z buffer will be enabled and we can go for having a view about the objects in the scene by having the depth buffer influence. That means the front objects, the back objects, the hidden objects, everything will be considered according to the depth buffer algorithm. This will be working and then you are going to get the output. So this is called as the enabling the GL depth test. As usual, we use the glut main loop at the end of the program to signify the end of all the events, the end of all callback functions, and end of all the APIs for the concerned program. Only then the glut system is going to close down. So this is the complete flow of the program. So the first function, what will be called, when we are writing the program, we usually write the functions first and then we are going to conclude the program with the main. But when I'm going to execute, the flow will be the opposite. So it starts from the main function, then goes to the display function. From the display function, I'm going to call 8 OBJ functions. So these 8 OBJ functions, they're going to in turn call the rotate APIs, the translate API, and the scaling API. All these APIs are applied on one solid cube one. That means a solid cube one is taken. Though we are writing the statement, the solid cube one at the last, after the rotation, translation, and scaling, but the matrix multiplication will happen for the solid cube objects and the rotation matrix and the translation matrix and the scaling matrix. Everything will be multiplied and you are going to get a new set of values for the cube num. This solid cube will be having the rotation, what has been specified in your rotation matrix given by the A3 APIs for the rotation. Also, it will be multiplied by the translation matrix contents, which is given in the translate API. It will also be multiplied with the values which is present in the scaling matrix specified by the scaling API. So after creating the 8 objects, what are the 8 objects we discussed? That is the 2 walls, 1 floor, and then we are going to have 4 table legs, and then we are having the table top. So these are the 8 objects what will be constructed. For all the 8 objects, the translation and the scaling, it will be different. But we are keeping the rotation the same. That means the angle of view of the entire scene, it is kept the same for all the objects. But some objects will be made smaller or bigger because we are using the solid cube one. By using the solid cube one, I am going to make the table legs. I am going to construct the table leg. By using the solid cube, I am going to construct the table top. And also by using the cube, I am going to construct 2 walls, the left wall and the right wall. And also by using the solid cube, I am going to make a floor. So the solid cube is the basis object. So 8 solid cubes are taken. And for all the 8 solid cubes, different translations and different rotations and different scalings are applied. And it has been reduced to the scene what is given over here. So 8 solid cubes. Now it will be transformed into 2 walls, 1 floor, 4 table legs and 1 tabletop. All these are solid cubes. Because we are having the transformation, now you can see how effectively these objects are seen. These objects are nothing but they are actually the solid cube 1. The solid cube 1 has been reduced on either on the x-axis, y-axis or on the z-axis. Then they're moved around in the scene and arranged neatly so that you are going to get a view of the teapot. So here we are also making use of the teapot. The teapot will be of size 0.09. That means we are having a teapot of smaller size. For this, I'm going to make use of the rotate and the translate. So when we make use of the rotate and the translate on the teapot, the value what I'm going to get here, the teapot what I'm going to get here, that means I take a teapot and I'm going to rotate it and I'm going to translate it. There is no scaling, as I told you, because the teapot itself will be having its value given as 0.09. means that means I'm considering a teapot of size 0.09. So there is no need to go for a separate scaling API here. So we have the rotate APIs and the translate applied on the teapot of size 0.09. You can look at the scene over here. So we are having one teapot. This teapot is placed on a table top. And then this table is consisting of four legs here. So all the four legs, they are of the same size only. The height is same. But because this is a behind, we can just make out the small part of this. This is the advantage what we get because of the depth buffer. The depth buffer algorithm when we are using, it enables that because the tabletop is present in before this one, we are not going to see the complete object of this particular table leg. So this table leg has been constructed by using a solid cube. We take a solid cube of size 1 and then we're going to reduce on the x-axis, y-axis and the z-axis. You can see here for the tabletop, the thickness will be given here based on the values what is given in the APIs, and then I'm going to get a tabletop. Similarly, for all the table legs also, we take a solid cube of size 1, then we give the transformations. What transformations we are going to apply? So by making use of the scaling, rotation and the translation, we can get all the objects over here. So this object, that is the wall, how we can get this wall? We take a solid cube of size 1 and then I'm going to reduce the x value over here and I'm going to get the left wall. So I'm going to reduce the x value. So you're going to get one wall over here. Similarly, when we go for reducing the z value, you can go for getting the right wall. And then the y value is reduced. When the y value is reduced, then you can get the floor. And then the teapot is a separate entity. By giving appropriate translation and rotation, there is no scaling. By applying appropriate translation and then the rotation, we can see that teapot is placed at this particular angle. So this is the scene what we have created. And the lighting and the material effect, that means for the front face, how it has to be seen. What is the amount of light what has to be falling on this object? That is given by the GL material FV and the GL light FV properties. So that is the end for this presentation. Thank you very much. Dear students, this is the output for the teapot program, program number 6 in the CGV lab manual. So you can look at the output over here. We have a teapot on a table, and the teapot, it is lying on a table with four legs, and then we also have two walls and a floor. Actually, the teapot is a separate entity. We can get that by making use of an API which is called as the GL teapot. If you give the command GL teapot, you are going to get it as a teapot. But The walls and the floor and the table legs as well as the table top are constructed by making use of a cube. So for a cube, when you remove the y parameter and you are going to compress it, it becomes a floor. And when you move it to the right side, that means you are going to compress the x value and move to the right. When you compress the z value and move to the left, in this way we are going to construct the walls and the floor. And the tabletop also, you can see it is very similar to the floor. The floor and the tabletop are constructed by taking a cube and then compressing on the y axis. That means we are going to press it from the top and it becomes flat. You can see that both of them are similar, and the dimensions will be changed by making use of the rotation, translation and scaling appropriately. This particular program is a little mini project for you, because here we are going to make use of the lighting, the material properties, also the transformations. So you have to just take a solid cube of size 1 and then we are going to reduce that. So in the program we will see how actually this is going to be achieved.